Hello and welcome to the online learning session ABB RoomTouch KNX Audio and Scene Control. Yeah, our online learning sessions take around 30 minutes. The focus is always on a special topic or on a function of a device. Today it's again the RoomTouch with audio and scene control. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings, and together with us is Martin and Jürgen, and Jürgen will present today. Yeah, you see here our team working at home. This will continue in the next time, so we will provide you in the next time with more online content and both webinars, but also our online learning sessions, of course. And let's have a look later what is planned for the next time, but you can expect more in the next future. Good, I would hand over to Jürgen now. He will continue, just a moment.
Hello and welcome. Jürgen Schilder is speaking and I present this online learning session. Thanks, Thorsten, for your introduction. What is on the agenda? Today, I will show you how the ABB RoomTouch first works with the ABB Push Control Touch and a Sonos speaker. And then I will introduce you the scene function. For this purpose, the ABB RoomTouch offers two special control elements. After a brief introduction to the RoomTouch, I come to these two control elements, audio and scene. Good, let's start at first with a short introduction about the ABB RoomTouch. Last month, we launched this new ABB RoomTouch KNX panel. The device is available in two colors. You can see here the black one and the white one, and it can mount it in a so-called portrait mode or landscape mode. The ABB RoomTouch offers enough functions for a room, like a meeting room, hotel room, or in a residential building. And we have several controls for lights, for blinds, for audio, for scenes, for temperatures, or to show values. Additionally, there's a temperature sensor integrated. We have a proximity sensor and a lot of more functions like screensavers. Now the commissioning still done via the ETS by the so-called DCA app. So now here you can see some pictures of a typical room. So with some several units or operating elements. So here on the right side, like example for the light, here in the middle, maybe for the aircon system, or here for the shutter. Or here, 10 of these conventional push buttons for the operation. Or here in a typical meeting room, we have a control units here for the light, maybe here for the audio system, or here for the shutters and things. And here you can see a so-called description or guidance how to operate all these different functions. But we can do it easier by using our KNX ABB RoomTouch. So we have one element, one touch display for all these functions, switching, dimming, audio control, scenes, and a lot of more functions. So the ABB RoomTouch offers maximum 30 of these control elements. With the control elements, we can switch, dim, control shutters, room temperature control is integrated. We can display some values like the CO2 concentration in a room. We can control split units, fans, DALI gateways. And today we put the focus here on the audio control and the scene function. So here on the right side, you can see such a control element for audio. And here later, I will explain more about the scenes, how to select the scenes and to trigger the scenes. More information are available on our training database. We have given some webinars and also online learning sessions about the RoomTouch. And more information about the products you will find on abb.com/knx. Go to the submenu visualization and there you will find all informations like the product manual, the KNX prod file, and of course, for free of charge, the ETS app, which is necessary for the commissioning. So first control today is the so-called control element audio control. So audio control means we can send here commands via KNX, for example, to the Push Control Touch, and the Push Control Touch converts this KNX twisted pair telegrams into special, IP telegrams that we can control here our Sonos speaker via patch cable or also via Wi-Fi access point also possible. So this is the example which I want to show you today, together communication with the control touch, how to set the parameters, how to link the group addresses, and so on. But this control element for the room touch is the audio control element is not limited for the push control touch. We have a wide range of parameters that we can also control other devices like an audio gateway. For example, here, this is a gateway for also Sonos speakers or an audio actuator. So there are a wide, there are some devices available on the market, but today we put a focus here on the ABB push control touch. So some words about this push control touch. It's a kind of KNX visualization. The device is a hardware, a DIN-rail component, and via the a smartphone or also the Apple Watch or the tablet, we can operate, for example, the complete KNX installation. The commissioning is done via the My Building portals. Plus, additionally, we have here built inside the gateway to Sonos, Philips Hue, and a lot of more functions. So more information about the push control touch, again, on our website and our training database, all the complete webinars, online recordings, like here the Sonos integrations, and so on. Good, then let's come now to the commissioning of this audio control together with our push control touch. So at first, we add here from the catalog a room touch, or we can still continue with our existing room touch in our ETS project. So, and then we create a new page. But what is now necessary, we have to click here on the so-called DCA. So the push room touch is not commissioned via the parameter windows. So now we need here this DCA app. So we will click here on the button DCA, and then we can see here our room touch. So then we have to set here at first the parameter that we can have maximum one control on this page, because the audio control element needs a complete page. So we set here the first parameter, only one page. And then via drag and drop, we take this control audio from our taskbar, and add it here to our page. So the next step is we click here on this page, and then you see it's orange marked, and then we set on the right side all the parameters. How many sources or playlists we want to control, do we want to use the shuffle mode, and so on. So the next step is then we have to link the group addresses. That's what we can do here inside this DCA app. So when we click here on our room touch device, then we get only all group objects of this audio control element. So not all, only of the selected element here. So on the right side, we have our group addresses, and then as usual, we can link the group addresses via drag and drop. So you have not to leave this DCA app and go here to the objects. You can do it here inside the DCA app. And the last step is download the individual address and the application, and that's all. Good, then let's come to the parameters of this audio control element. So I showed you on the next three slides. So let's start with the first parameter, is the name of the control element. This is, for example, what the end user later can see. Maybe you write here music, or you write here the name of the room, what do you want. So this is later displayed in the room touch. The number of the sources, maximum 8. 8 means we can call up to 8 different playlists or radio station, 6 radio stations, 2 playlists. So maximum we can call up to 8 different of these sources. So, and then the next parameter we have, when we select only one source, then we get here source number 1. When we select 8 sources, then we get here 8 times source, the name, the type, and the value. So we write here the name, source 1. In real, you will write here, maybe this is your radio station or the name of your playlist. The source, it's a 1-bit or 1-byte. It's recommended to use the 1-byte. And then depending on the value, if the value is 1, then we call the first favorite. If the value is 5, we call the fifth favorite in our playlist. So the next one is for the play and pause control. It's a 1-bit or 1-byte. Default, it is 1-bit with the value 1 for play the music, and the value 0 for pause. So this is what we can keep it like this. The next one, do we want to use the forward and the backward control? Like for example, when we have started a playlist, yes. And then we can select here also a 1-bit or 1-byte. Default, it is a 1-bit with the value 1, for example, for forward, and the value 0 for backward. Or we can say forward and backward both are 1 because we have here 2 different group objects. So next parameter, do we want to use the mute control? Yes, and then we have again 1-bit or 1-byte, and with the value 1, we enable the mute function, and with value 0, unmute. So these are default parameters, we can keep it like it is if we want to control here our room touch. Shuffle control, yes or no, again, shuffle value 1, no shuffle, value 0. Repeat function, yes, the same, value 1 or value 0, so it is also here possible. Good, next step, the volume control. Yes, we want to use this, of course. So how we want to control the volume? We are two 1-bit objects, one 4-bit object. Then we use it like dimming. You know, dimming is start dimming brighter, stop dimming brighter, start dimming darker, stop dimming darker. The same we can do here via a 4-bit telegram. Or the best way is to use the 1-byte value, and then we can send here a value between 0 and 100%, like 50%, 20%, and so on. The volume change, so when we press here our plus button or the minus button for the volume, then every time we send a telegram, yeah, plus 5%, plus 5%, with a time difference here of a half second. On-off control, use yes or no, and when you say yes, then we get a value for 1. For on is the 1 and the value for off for 0. So it's not really difficult. And if you want to use here the enable communication function, it means via 1-bit via 1-bit telegram with the value 1, we can disable this control. So maybe when the end user removes the key card and then the 1-bit information here disables this control element and no one can still operate it. This is still possible. Good, I think not really difficult. The parameters. I have here made an example how it works here with my room touch and my Sonos speaker together with the control touch. So let's have a look at some parameters. I use all 8 sources. So for example, the source number 1 is my radio station, Radio Bavaria. Source number 8 is my radio station SWR3. And for example, number 10 is my playlist of the relaxing music. So maximum we can have 8 sources. So I have enabled here 8 sources. So I write here source number 2, my radio SWR3. It's a 1-byte value I want to send. And the value is 8 because this is my number 8, the radio station of my favorites in my Sonos system. So or here for my playlist for the relaxing music, this is the number 10 in the playlist or the favorites of my Sonos system. So I send here later than the value 10. Of course, I want to use the on-off, the play and the pause function. So as a 1-bit, so I send the value 1 for playing and the value 0 for pause. And for backward, the same when I use it. Yeah, but here with the value 1, I go forward and with the value 1, I go backward. Because I have here 2 different group objects. And I want to use, of course, the control, the volume control with a range from 100 to from 0 to 100%. And every time when I press here the plus or minus button, we send a new value, 5% plus 5% and so on. Good, these are the settings I have made here in the control, in the control, audio control and the room touch. So here you can see a screenshot of my Sonos app. So I'm here in my Sonos favorites, and here you can see the list of all the radio stations and the playlist. Like for example here, number 1, this is my Radio Bavaria, number 8 is my radio station SWS3, and here you see the playlist of my relaxing music, this is number 10. So these values 1, 8 and 10 I send here via my sources when I press the buttons. Good, here you can see a screenshot of the push control app. So now when you operate your Sonos system via the mobile phone or via your tablet, then you can see here, for example, on the left side, this page for playing and for stop, change the volume, or here the shuffle mode, backwards and forwards. So on the next page, we can here select our playlist and our radio stations. That's what we do via the room touch, but you can do it here also via the push control touch app. So then let's go to the control touch. So the configuration is done via the My Building portals. So you have to log into the My Building portals, go to the projects menu, and then we have here the submenu Sonos KNX linking. And then you get a list of all your Sonos speakers. Then you select here one Sonos speaker, like this is my Sonos speaker here in my office. So and then I get here the different group objects where I can now link the group addresses. Like for example, the device volume is exactly the information in percent which I receive here from the room touch. I link here the group address. It's a little bit tricky because here this is maybe the column for the status group address. This is so the so-called incoming group address. Here this is the group address we send from the room touch to the control touch. And here the so-called sending group address is then the status. So when he receives the telegram, go to 50%, then the volume goes to 50%, and he sends back this status to KNX, now I'm 50%. Yeah, and the same is here, for example, for playing. So here we send a 1-bit information with the value 1, and then he starts playing this speaker in my office, and then he responds with the value 1 with this group address, yeah, that he's playing the music. So then we link here our group addresses. We have here on top our group address view, and then we can via drag and drop here link the group addresses. The same, for example, here for the shuffle mode, yeah, or for the repetition, yeah, or here go forward or backwards. This is what we can also do here. Or just here we link the group address of our favorites. Good. So here then the overview for the linking of the group addresses between our room touch here on the left side and our push control touch. So at first we can link a group address with the meta information. That's the name here, yeah, in the control touch. It can be, for example, the drag name. This is a 14-byte information, and then we can see here, for example, the title or the artist or the album, yeah, or some streaming informations as a 14-byte value. So this is one group address. So then for playing and for pause, we link again a group address here from play to play status GA. This is the input, and here for pause. So and back then the status, yeah, that he is playing music or that the pause is now active. Next two group addresses we need here for skip forward to this input, and another group address for skip backward here to previous. So the name is here a little bit different, but you can see it's the same. Skip forward, it means here next, and skip backward is previous. So when we use the mute function, then we need again a group address, yeah, here to enable the mute function, send the function device mute, and then he sent back the status, now he's muted. It makes sense, of course, to link back here the status, because when you operate the control touch via your smartphone, yeah, and you mute the device, and then he still sends back the information that he's muted, and then you can see here the icon mute is now active. So for the shuffle, the same, if you want to use it, 1-bit here, activate the shuffle, and another group address here back for the status. For volume control, we link here again a group address. This is the 1-byte group address for the value of the volume, and then he sent also back here the status. And for the source, remember we have maximum 8 sources, radio stations or playlist. We can link, or we can use always the same group address. The only difference is here that the objects have different values. 1 is my SWR3, or 10, for example, is my playlist for my relaxing music. And link these group addresses here in our control touch to the objects select favorite / playlist. Good, this is the example how to link the group addresses between here our push control touch and the push room touch. Good, then let's have a look at a group monitor. Now I have recorded here some telegrams. So for example, here the first telegram is from the ABB room touch. Yeah, I pressed here one button for my favorite playlist. And then you will see he sent here a group address, which has the value 10. So this is my playlist for my relaxing music. And then he sends back information that the state is playing with the value 1. So he starts playing the music. And for example, he sends back here the title, yeah, which is here an Italian song, for example. Okay, when I change the volume and the room touch, so I press here and hold the button plus or minus, and then you will see he sent now 27%. If I press again or hold longer, and then he repeats the telegram, plus 5%, and he sent the value 32%. So when I press here the button skip forward, like increase, yeah, and then he jumps to the next title, and you will see the control touch, yeah, answers with the new, with the next name of this song, like here, also Italian song. Yeah. When I activate the shuffle function, yeah, you will see shuffle is now enabled, and then the control touch responds with the value 1 that the status is active. Good, and so on. Or here the mute function. So this is, I think, not really difficult when you link the group addresses like before I have shown you. Good, here you can see the room touch in the so-called landscape mode. So we need here, or we need a complete page for operating our audio elements. So on first, we see here the name of the page that we can set, and here also the name of the control element. You can write here music or living room, and here the title, artist or album. These are the 14-byte telegrams we can display here. So via this button, we can play or pause. here with forward or backwards. For example, when we play a playlist, and here with plus and minus, we can change the volume. So you can tap here. Every time you tap, plus 5%, or you can hold the finger, yeah, and then he repeats the plus every half second. So here we can see that the mute function is active or deactive, or we can also enable here the mute function by tapping the shuffle mode, the repeat mode, and here we can go to our next source or favorite playlist. That's what I show you later. So here on the left side, we can see the so-called portrait mode, like here our element with plus and minus, you can change the volume, or here we can play and pause. When you click here on these three dots, then we jump to the next, to another page. Yeah, and on this page, we can here also go forwards or backwards. We can here shuffle. We can here also activate, for example, then the mute function and change here also the volume. Good. So and here the landscape mode, yeah, the same for playing forwards, backwards. And here when we press on this button source, then we jump here to our maximum 8 sources we have defined. Here you can see the name of the 8 sources, and you can press here and then he sent this value to the bus and the starts playing this radio station or here this music. Good, so far how to use the audio control element. Then let's come to the next topic, the so-called scenes. So with the scene function, we can call or we can also store a scene. So the typical 8-bit scene, this is according to the KNX data point type 18001. So what does it mean? With one telegram, we can call, and it's a parameter, we can store up to 64 scenes. So this is the option of storing the scenes. So the big advantage is here, we send only one command, one KNX telegram, and depending on the value, we can call or store up to 64 different scenes, one single telegram. So the information on, off, the brightness value, purple, like when we use DALI, for example, the position of the lamellas, slats, the angle, yeah, or the about HVAC, our set point and such things. Yeah, this information are all stored in the actuator. So we send only command, yeah, and then the device looks inside, yeah, the values, and then he knows what he have to do. That's the principle of this 8-bit scene. So, okay, what happens? We press here one button, like typically here in a residential home. We press here our we come at home, we open the door, we press here the welcome button, and then he calls the scene number 4, for example, which is our welcome scene. Some lights go on, maybe here in the entrance area, 80%, or in the living room, maybe in the kitchen. Yeah, some sockets outlets are switched on, the shutters drives in a position open or close or something. The security system gets unset. Yeah, the room temperature control system goes, for example, here to the comfort mode. Yeah, we call some lights here, like in our living room, for example. Music starts playing, our Sonos system, yeah, plays my favorite playlist. Yeah, the Philips Hue system is now also integrated, and so on. So this is the principle of the 8-bit scene. So typical scenes like in a training room, yeah, we can have different scenes for welcome or when you start a presentation, when we have coffee break, and a hotel room when we insert a key card, remove the key card, such things in residential home, yeah, or room occupied or not. So many applications for this 8-bit scene. Good. In the scene, we can integrate the light, curtains, HVAC, music, security, audio media, all kind of KNX devices. So depending, yeah, what fits to us. And it's not only on off like a central, because we can switch some lights on, percentage and so on. So we have more advantage than only here on off. And for the end user, we offer another possibility that the end user can store the scenes. Yeah, so for example, between summer and winter, he wants to have different scenes in his living room. Yeah, and then he can store the scene. Good, then let's come to this commissioning of the scene function. So again, we add the room touch in a project, or we still continue with an existing device. Yeah, do not forget to click on the button DCA for setting all the parameters. So, and then we have to set a number of controls for this page, one or two, so we cannot have through controls. So such a scene button needs maybe the complete page or a half page. So one or two. And then again, from the taskbar via drag and drop, we take here our button and add it here to our page. Then we set again all the parameters, which I'll show you in the next slides, of the of this scene button. Then we link again the group addresses here inside the DC app, download, and so on. Good, then let's have a look at the parameters. At first here, the name of the control, for example. Yeah, you can enter the name which is later displayed in the room touch for the end user. So, and then, for example, the next button is start the scene as it's selected, yes or no. It means when you scroll between the scenes and you remove your finger, then he calls the scene, or you have to tap again on this scene to confirm it. So, long operation, about 0.6 seconds or longer. This is, for example, when we store the scene later. So, call means when we press short, and when the end user wants to store the new scene, then he press longer than this time here. Number of scenes, for example, maximum we can call here up to 10 different scenes. Yeah, 1 to 10. I have here in my example 5 scenes. So then we enter here the name, the number of the scene. Remember, 1 to 64. Like, for example, this is my scene number 1. And here the name welcome. This is what the end user later can see. And the room touch, when he scroll up and down, then he get here the name of the scene. Like welcome, yeah, or here start presentation. This is, for example, my scene number 21 is, for example, my scene for the coffee break, scene number 4 for the stop presentation, and scene number 5 for end presentation. So, and if it should be possible to store the scene, then we have to tick here. You see store scene number 1 by long press when we say yes, and then the end user later can store the scene. Good. How to store the scene? I showed here on this slide. So, the first step is, so the end user set the situation in his room or like he wants, for example, switch this light on, dim darker, drive the shutter in this position, yeah, and so on, like he wants the situation in his room. So, and then he goes to the scene, select the scene, press here on this scene number and hold his finger. So then you will see a blue bar here is running on top, yeah, and then at the end he get the confirmation that the scene is saved. So now when he was doing exactly this step, the room touch sent now a command, call this scene. So he sent the command, store this scene. So this difference between short, then we call the scene, and long, we store the scene. So, but for this function, you have to enable here the parameter, store scene by pressing. And so there's a possibility that the end user can change his scenes between maybe summer and winter, for example, because he want to have different situation of the light or the position of the shutter. Good, how to link the group addresses? Not really difficult. We need only one group address, because with one group address we can call up to 64 different scenes. So we get here the objects scene number 1, 2, 3 up to scene number 10. Then we create one group address and link it here to all our scenes and send it here to our actuators. It can be switch actuator, dim actuator, DALI gateway, and so on, and we link the group address to the scene objects like output A, output B, output D, output X here of our devices. That's what we all have to do, only one single group address. So now when we have a look at a group monitor, then you will see I press here the button and then I send here command activate scene number 4. This means call scene number 4. Then next step, activate number 5, number 1. So I've called here different scenes, but it's only one telegram, one group address. And depending on the value, you can see here we call different scenes. And the last telegram here, I have pressed long, and then he sent the command learn scene number 1 or store, for example. Let's say store. And then all devices which are linked with the group address, they know, okay, I have now to store my value, which I have at the moment, and the next time when I call the scene number 1, I can also get the same situation like I have stored the scene. Good, so far, then let's go to the operation overview here. Again, on the right side, you can see the room touch in the so-called landscape mode. Here we can have maximum 2 controls, like here on the left side, I have a scene button. You see here the welcome, this is the name of the scene. And by swiping here up and down, I can change here between or select or scroll between my different scenes. And when I tap on the scene, then I call the scene. So here on the left side, you can see the portrait mode. So you have here on the page different controls, like here is my scene button. So here we are via these arrows, I can scroll between my different scenes, like my welcome, my start presentation, my coffee break, and then I can tap here and call the scene. So if I want to do more, I can click here or tap here on these three dots, and then a new page opens, my scene page. And here we are scrolling. I can also select here a scene like my start presentation, my break, stop presentation, and here then I can call the scene. Good. In the landscape mode, it is similar. Yeah, we are scrolling. I can here select my scene which I want, and by tapping then I call the scene. So this is the same function. Good. So far, my presentation about the ABB Room Touch together with the Control Touch and a Sono speaker. I would like to say thank you for listening, and I hand back to Thorsten. Goodbye.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. Great. First up, two powerful functions inside the ABB Room Touch KNX. Yeah, audio control. I think many of you have, or many other customers have, Sono speakers. So further option to operate is now via a KNX device. Centrally, of course, you can still use it or operate it via the mobile app of Bush Control Touch. Of course, it's also possible. Yeah, and scene is nothing special, only a nice way to operate now, also from the ABB Room Touch. I come to my last slides, as always. Yeah, you find everything around the Room Touch on our homepage at the product page. As always, training material are stored on our training and qualification database. Also, this session will be stored in our calendar. We have at the moment only on our online learning sessions. No classroom, no presence trainings possible in the factories. This also results in no certified training. Still this year, something was planned. We will see what is possible next year, but at the moment, no presence or classroom trainings. So how do we continue? Webinar next month with a new KNX switch actuators with energy functions coming soon, beginning of next month on the market. And we have extended our range of switch actuators with KNX switch actuator with energy functions, so-called. It's a different hardware with measurement behind. And you see also the QAS 161 KNX energy analyzer, which can work together for a powerful solution with our new switch actuators with energy functions. 11th of November, we will show how it works and what's behind. And then, as mentioned, we have still some content for the Room Touch, because we cannot fill anything, or could not fill everything in one last session. So there will be one more session on the 12th of November for alarm messages, time programs, and then maybe some more further small functions of the ABB Room Touch. Okay, so thank you, Jürgen, was great. The Room Touch is a really powerful device. Hope to see you next time in 2 weeks, less than 2 weeks, with the webinar on the 11th. Thank you for your participation. See you. Bye-bye. Ciao.